Hello, this is KRBrickBot, and wouldn't you know it, Transformers War for Cybertron E Earthrise is in Korea. Online only, but better than nothing. And here I was, just moping about thinking, oh, they're not gonna bring Earthrise until October, and only Optimus Prime, Starscream, Bumblebee, and the two big guys. But no, it looks like they're in parity with the rest of the world, and they imported almost all of Wave 1, except the little guys. What's wrong with the Micromasters and Battlemasters? And they might have come in as early as December or February. And I discovered it just now in May. And consequently, most of the good stuff was sold out in the other stores, just leaving poor old nobody Ironworks. But there was one mall store left that had all of the Deluxes and Voyagers, so I picked it up from there. Although it's a slight markup from its original Siege counterparts. Yeah, but better than nothing or American shipping prices. So that said, let's unbox this thing. Yep, I got the three deluxes that were mostly sold out everywhere else. Wheeljack, Cliffjumper, and Hoist. And the Voyager Starscream. So yeah, Earthrise. So as you see here, Hasbro Far East, LTD, 2020 January. Yeah, Starscream is December of 2019. Yay, Earthrise! Okay, I guess I'll get to unboxing these guys. So I took some time to transform them into their vehicle modes. And they look pretty great for the most part. Now, if I have to nitpick about some of the paint discrepancies, mine has a little black smudge on here, on Cliffjumper. Right there. So I'm not sure if this entire body is painted red because I'm not comfortable just magic soaping that off. Yeah, Wheeljack here. Yeah, it's just nice creamy white. This spoiler has some silver splotches. And I have the Unite Warriors Wheeljack, so yeah, I know. So yeah, this is more accurate and more detailed, but this one's slightly bigger. Hoist. Yeah, good old Hoist. And Trailbreaker. And classic Starscream. I mean, Earthrise Starscream, yeah, but this is a really great jet mode we have in the wild. Most G-money jet. And quite bigger compared to his Siege counterpart. Still have to complain about those minor red splotches, though. Also, this wing is slightly too easily poppable for my liking. Just like the old G-1 Seekers. Speaking of which, did any toy reviewer mention that all of these are constructed with pin hinges now? No screws or anything? Going to be challenging for customizers. All pins and plastic swivels. This seems like a good sign Hasbro Korea is more open to more imports. So, with Wave 1 Deluxes, Voyagers, and Leaders released, I'm hoping to see the other waves will be released in full. Yeah, but I imagine the selects and the exclusive multi-packs will still be elusive to us Koreans. Just have to import it from the States or such. And the other Transformers products they imported recently are a bunch of the new Bumblebee Cyberverse Adventures Warriors, all four of the Wave 1 Deluxes, maybe a Studio Series or two, and even MP13 and MP36?
Say what?
So if you're a Transformers collector living in Korea, you don't necessarily have to import everything from Amazon now. Currently, they're only being sold online in the mall-type big sellers. Unless those malls have like large department store locations, I don't see them being sold in offline stores just to be obscurely passed by on by the kids who have absolutely no idea who these guys are. I just might complete the Earthrise Wave 1 collection with Astro Train and Prime and Grapple. Maybe Jetfire, yeah, Siege Jetfire is still available. But I probably kind of put more of my priority toward the Korean robots, but I'm kind of running low this month, in case you haven't seen. So time will tell.
Thanks for watching, and be sure to like and subscribe. So until next time, this is KRBrickBot signing off.